Now, I become Muslim in 1968. Not because I was given the Quran, because you know the majority of the Muslims do not allow people who are not yet Muslim even touch the Quran. How can we read the Quran if you're not given the opportunity even to touch the Quran? Is there any significance in touching the Quran? No. Allah only reward you if you read the Quran, not touching. Touching have no significance. But the way majority of the Muslims understand the Quran is so holy, you cannot touch it. لا يمسه إلا المطهرون. In Surah Al-Waqi'ah, Allah said, Quran cannot be touched except people who are clean. Allah never said the Quran that is with you. He said the Quran that is now in Mahfuz. Kitab Maqnun. Nobody can touch that Quran in Lawhi Mahfuz except the angels. But to human, Allah said, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن خدّل للناس. For mankind, so what right do you have to stop people who are not yet Muslim to read the Quran? You have no right at all. If you do that, you commit a sin. Because you are going against Allah's command. He said that I reveal the Quran as the final revelation for all mankind. So who are you to stop other people from reading Quran? I came to Islam after reading the history of Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab, who came to Islam after hearing his brother-in-law reciting Surah Taha. There's a difference. Umar, Allah gave hidayah through the recitation of Surah Taha, the Quran, by his brother-in-law. I cannot read the Quran, the Muslims don't give it to me. Because you are Chinese, you cannot read. Nothing to do with the Quran. This Quran is for Muslim. And in our country, Muslim are Malays, so for the Malays. Maybe here, there are certain Muslim groups, it's only for them. So we have no chance to read the Quran. We can read some other books. Alhamdulillah, I read the book of Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab, who got hidayah from the Quran. You see how important for you to show the Quran to your friend, to share with the people. Hudal linnas wa bayinat min al huda wal furqan. Quran also is a bayinat. It's a clear sign. Nothing is hidden. It's very clear. What is white is white. Black is black. Halal is halal. Haram is haram. Shirk is shirk. Tawhid is tawhid. Bid'ah is bid'ah. Sunnah is sunnah. They don't compromise. It's a very clear thing. As Muslim, if you always guide yourself by the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet, you will never be confused. You get confused because you do not follow the Quran and the Sunnah. Then you create a lot of confusion. And the Quran also is named by Allah as Nur, light. It will enlighten you if you open yourself to the Quran. Allow the Quran to come into your life. The Quran will enlighten you. The Quran will give you peace. Because it's a zikr. الَّبِي ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَعِنُ الْقُلُوبِ. It's a zikr. It's a reminder. The best reminder is the reminder from Allah. And by remember Allah, Allah give you inner peace.